Hi everyone, if you watch the last few videos, you might know that we were going through Colossians 1, 15 to 20, which is what many people call it, the poem that Paul wrote about Christ. And we saw how this poem tells us a lot about the person of Christ and about how Christ in relation to creation and Christ in relation to the church. And now that we're transitioning to the next section, you can see, or we can see, how is that Paul ends verse 20, which is actually what he uses to transition to the next section. Because if you can see, if you're reading with me, we can read together verse 20. It says, through him to reconcile to himself all things, whether on earth or in heaven, making peace by the blood of his cross. So that's the last verse from the poem, and now we can see how Paul continues this thinking about reconciliation and talks about our need for that reconciliation, and also points out or reminded us or remind the Colossians how was their life before Christ, before they have that reconciliation with God. And we see it very clear here in Colossians 1:21 when it says, once you were alienated from God and were enemies in your minds because of your evil behavior. I feel like sometimes we forget just this statement. We forget that we were at some point alienated from God. That we were God's enemies. And we forget that it was only because of his grace and because of Christ's sacrifice that we know the truth, that we can follow him. That we can now know how he wants us to live. And maybe, you know, I know that maybe some people have been born in the Christian church and haven't seen that clear separation, right? Of like people like me who believe later, you know, have a clear, I was living my entire life very separate, you know, from God, doing bad things and stuff like that. But we know that everyone, even though you're born in a Christian church, you know, with everyone, we're separated from God, right? We see this in Romans and in many other letters from Paul, that we're separated because of our sin, and that only through Christ we can have that reconciliation. And it's only through him that we can have that. And there's still a lot of people in the world that don't have that, and they're living a life not knowing this truth, not knowing what Christ did for us in the cross. And that is basically what Paul says in the next phrase, in this verse, in verse 21, that Christ has now reconciled in his body of flesh by his death. So again, you know, here Paul is reinforcing that gospel, right? The gospel that we know, the way that we know it, right? That only through Christ's death, through his body, and what he did in the cross for us, that we can obtain that reconciliation. And we can clearly see here in these verses how he moved us from being God's enemy, from being alienated from God, to be people who are holy and blameless and above reproach. And that is our goal. We see this right in many verses in the New Testament, to seek that holiness. And then in a very simple way, in verse 23, Paul explains that in order to seek and obtain that holiness, the believer needs to continue in your faith, established and firm, and do not move from the hope held out in the gospel. So, you know, that's simple statement. It tells us, right? That process of seeking that holiness is continuing in the faith. See, now we know that those who are in Christ are secure in him. But we know that in this life, as we continue to seek to become more like Christ, as we seek that holiness that Paul is telling here, we need to continue in our faith. We need to continue persevering in our faith. And also, just like the verse here in 23 says, to not move from our hope that we